Versatile Muslima. Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. One of the most controversial ayah in Quran is in Surah An-Nisa, verse 34, which gives husbands some instructions on how to deal with a wife who is arrogant and disrespectful. The word wadribuhunna is used in Quran, which is commonly translated as beat them or strike them. We will first look at this word closely. Friends, this word has more than 20 meanings in Arabic language. One of the meaning is to move away or stay away from. If we look at the sunnah of our Prophet, he never hit anyone. And whenever he was faced with marital disagreements, he moved away from his wives. And if the ayah only means beat them, then do you think that our Prophet disobeyed the Quran? Astaghfirullah. If we further investigate, we find that this word darb is also used in tayammum, that you should do darb upon the earth, which means you tap the earth for ablution. It cannot mean that you beat or strike the earth. You can also see that Sahaba radiallahu anha would not beat their wives. They used a siwak or miswak to tap a woman who is not even ready to look in her husband's direction to listen to him. Sisters, Islam does not take any abuse lightly. If a man were to hit any woman, she has the right to take this matter to the Islamic court, where the attacker will be punished or fined. When a woman becomes a wife, her rights are increased. Do you know that a marriage can be nullified on the basis of domestic violence? A woman has the right to take divorce from an abusive husband because Islam does not tolerate any kind of violence against women. In Khutbatul Wida, our Prophet warned men regarding their women. He said, "Fear Allah with regards to Imat Allah." Imat Allah means female slaves of Allah. The reason why he said female slave of Allah, so the men should know that they don't own their wives. Their women belongs to Allah and He has given them to you as a trust. If you mistreat them, Allah will punish you for breaking His trust. Coming back to the ayah, Surah An-Nisa deals with many exceptional cases like polygamy or inheritance law. If we agree for the sake of argument that this verse does allow a man to lightly beat his wife, we must understand the circumstances in which this darb is allowed. It deals with an exceptional case of a woman being disloyal to her husband. For example, if a man fears that his wife is cheating on him, he should advise her or admonish her because he is not sure about his doubts. When he sees that his wife is not obeying him, he should forsake her in bed, that is, sleep separately, and wait that his wife may fear Allah. But if one day it goes worse and he catches her with another man and he is sure that she is unfaithful to him, then he can lightly beat her. Friends, let's be honest to ourselves. Is that a harsh punishment for a woman who is cheating on her husband, ruining her kid's life just for fun? I understand that men cheat too and Islam gives women the right to take khula or divorce. Don't think that why can't I beat my husband? Because if any woman were to beat her husband, there will be a reaction which will be more painful for her. So don't be emotional and think logically. A wife cheating on her husband is not a norm, it's an exceptional case. So this darb is only for that case. Men can't lightly beat their wives just because she added more salt in food or she didn't greeted his parents appropriately. Sisters, you must also realize that Allah has given men some favor over their wives just to protect the family system. It is not there to degrade you. Have a look of Western countries and see what filth they are into just because they have broken the family systems long ago. Please share this video as much as you can and let's end this misconception about Islam. I'll see you soon with a new video. Jazakallah.